Established in 2018, the State House Anti-Corruption Unit says it has made great success in fighting corruption in the various government departments. Mariam Natasha, the Public Relations Officer of the State House Anti-Corruption Unit, reveals that since 2018, over 512,000 complaints have been received at the unit, and among these 521 accused persons have been arraigned in courts of law. 87 people have so far been convicted, and majority of these are public officials. The unit has also been able to recover over 55 billion shillings since inception.
We were officially opened in December 2018, so I think we count from 2019 to date. We've recovered over 55 billion from savings and recoveries. And we have arraigned 521 persons in courts. And we have convicted, of these, of the 521, 87 have been convicted since.
Natasha attributed this to the close coordination with other anti-corruption agencies, civil society organizations, as well as citizens who in most cases act as the whistleblowers.
Our role is to coordinate these different agencies. Yes, and in coordinating these different agencies means that when we receive cases, we cannot work on them in individuality. We need to work with others. For example, all our cases are investigated by the CID, which is part of police. Some of the cases are referred to IGG. If there are audit queries, auditor general, if there are procurement queries, PPDS, meaning we all have to get, we must, it's not even an option, we must come together and work together.
For a long time, the citizens and many other people have looked at the war against corruption as a fight for only the anti-corruption agencies. However, we are now bringing it to the people and all the other stakeholders to inform them that when you're fighting a war, you can't leave it to the few. We have to muscle up and join forces and to take on this war together.
During the anti-corruption marathon held over the weekend at Amanang Secondary School in Bukwa District, various key stakeholders sensitized the locals on dangers related to corruption as well as several means through which this vice can be defeated.
It is citizens who are on the receiving end of corruption. Citizens deserve quality public services. Most times they are denied quality public services by corruption. Citizens are taxpayers. The taxes that are used to procure public services and most time end up being stolen, and therefore they deserve better, especially if they are taxpayers.
Some of the residents reveal that corruption was largely responsible for the poor services.
Sometimes I refer cases to the police, but we have a very big challenge at our police. Now, those people are the most corrupt, if at all I can say, because they cannot handle a case without money. Let's assume someone has brought a case just from within the station, but you can imagine that that person is going to be asked for 50,000 for the transport to bring that suspect.
There were issues to do with the ghost projects. All this were investigated by the office of the IGG and all these other government anti-corruption agencies.
This year's anti-corruption marathon held in Bukwa District was under the theme Strengthening Partnership in the War Against Corruption. The annual event brings together all agencies to take stock of the achievements attained in the war against corruption as well as make more recommendations on how the vice can be totally eliminated. Report compiled by Rachel Nachiwala for the news.